The AI wars continue among the world's tech giants. OpenAI has beefed up its ChatGPT generative AI chatbot with search engine capabilities as it takes on Google's dominance on web search. The upgrade enables users to receive fast and timely answers with links to relevant web sources. This allows ChatGPT to provide real-time information from across the web. Meanwhile, Google Maps and Waze getting an upgrade as well. The tech giants now applying generative AI with Gemini models to Google Maps with the help of Gemini. Google Maps can also come up with a summary of customer reviews of places to visit and even show answers to frequently asked questions about the spot. Google also said it is introducing new AI-driven changes to navigation map app Waze. Drivers using Waze will soon be able to tap on the reporting button in the app, then speak normally in English. Thousands are flocking to cemeteries nationwide to visit their departed loved ones this All Souls Day holiday. Let's get an update on the situation at the Manila South Cemetery, where over 500,000 visitors are expected to troop there. Andrea Taguinas joins us live from the Manila South Cemetery. Andy, what's happening so far?
Stanley, it's not even the end of the day yet, but the foot traffic here at the Manila South Cemetery has far exceeded the crowd estimate from yesterday, October 31. As of 3 p.m., authorities have tallied visitors of up to 76,000. And as the crowd gets thicker, we also see the lines for the bathrooms and the free e-trike rides get longer and longer. Earlier today, two metal staircases that crossed over the walls of the cemetery were installed along Metropolitan Avenue and Kalayaan Avenue in Makati with the goal of providing additional entry points for people visiting their departed loved ones. However, some senior citizens arrived even before the stairs were set up, so they still had to walk all the way to the main gate. Authorities also saw it fit to temporarily suspend the use of the stairs over at Metropolitan Avenue less than an hour since it was open to the public. Because of certain deficiencies, like the lack of a railing on one side, one of the steps got broken already, there was also a gap between the stairs and the bridge at the top, which authorities said could potentially lead to an accident. This whole incident resulted in a lot of complaints by visitors, especially the dozens who had to wait by the sidewalk under the heat of the sun while the stairs were being fixed.
Naglakad kami from there hanggang dito. Eh, we are all senior citizens. Ang sabi ng mga police, nagtanong kami, ginagawa pa daw. Sabi ko, late na. Dapat 1 ngayon, sa pag 30 o 31 pa lang, ginawan na nila para ganito.
Sabihin mo, tapusin ha, kay importante pagkadto sa cementerio. Hangka buwasan kami dito, ang kakainin namin.
Sana nag-provide sila ng service or ng e-bike. Di ba ganun yung parang, ano? Kasi 1 year din naman itong pinag-prepare, di ba? So parang taon-taon naman nangyayari, pero bakit parang walang preparation, na parang walang contingency plan sa may mangyaring ganito?
Stanley, the management of the Manila South Cemetery has apologized for the inconvenience that the faulty stairs has caused to the public. But when we interviewed the director, Mr. Henry D., a while ago, he clarified that this is the initiative of the Makati City Local Government Unit. So they would first have to coordinate with them and see what went wrong with the planning of this project. Otherwise, he said they don't really have anything to do with it. But when we spoke to the Makati LGU, they said that this is actually, the metal stairs are actually a private sector initiative. So they're also washing their hands clean of that. And when we asked if the cemetery has plans to just build another gate or another entrance as suggested by some visitors so that there wouldn't be need for stairs, Henry D. said that they're not considering that option since they are more concerned about the safety and security of the people, which he said they can better monitor if there is only one entry and exit point. Meanwhile, Dee also reminded people to practice Clay-go or clean as you go during their stay here at the cemetery. Back to you, Stanley.
Yes, Andy, about the metal stairs, is there any formal advice now? I mean, they have to resolve the issue. They have to be clear about communicating if, in fact, those stairs are still available for use. Assuming that between now and for the rest of the evening, moving forwards, more people will still be going to visit their dead, departed loved ones at the Makati South or Manila South Cemetery. So authorities there better be clear about those instructions.
Yes, Danny, last time we checked, it was still being restricted for public use, but we'll try to see later on if it will be able to if they will be able to open it to the public as the crowds do get bigger and bigger here at the Manila South Cemetery.
All right, thank you so much for the update, Andrea Taguines.